Welcome to SKTV. Welcome, 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 welcome. We're taking you back into the days of Logger Doobie. Happy Father's Day. Welcome to everyone today, Sunday, Father's Day. We are here on Truth FM. Here today, our man filling in or helping us with this program is Salomon M. Tobe. Salomon, I heard you playing some of that Logger Doobie Sunny Order. My man dropped that thing. Let me yes. Hey, been a while, aren't you with Doobie? Yeah.
I come here. Let me drop it. The title of this song is called Back to My Root.
Folks, today is Father's Day. Welcome to the program. I beg you. My man, we got anything on this out. We in the diaspora. We got the song. Hey, now you're talking. I beg you. Nobody's there. Yeah, my love. I think yeah. I don't know if I'm going to the roof today. I see some more than time if they're pushing them more. Yo, bottle. I want to take
it. Yeah.
Some more than that. Oh, that's hell. We're kidding. Today we're playing host of the responsibility of the CPP and also the Liberty Party, but the CPP at large. We're playing host to Chairman Musa Bility here today. Lots of things to cover here, folks. But my man Miss Noble always said, don't you dare change the dial. Please stick and stay with us this afternoon. In Monrovia, in Ganta, wherever you are listening to us via the radio, we say stick and stay with us. It promises to be very interesting this afternoon as Salomon will be controlling the steering here this afternoon to help us with the program. Somebody say there is a feedback from the sounding over there. Salomon, would you please help us with the feedback?
Yeah.
Folks, happy Father's Day to all of the fathers. Especially those who are taking care of their responsibility. Happy Father's Day to you. If you're taking care of responsibility as a father, nothing wrong. You can stay catch up. You can stay take care of responsibility. Today we'll be playing host of Chairman Musa Bility. Lots of things to cover here, folks. So we have lots of things to talk about. Those of you listening to us via the radio, please stick and stay with us. Stick and stay with us. Invite someone. I think someone said to me that my internet is a little blurry today. Yes, I'm not sure what's going on, but I believe it will catch up in a little bit here. I've done everything I can from a technical standpoint. Sekou will be joining us momentarily. Folks, let's share the show. Today is Father's Day. Those of our people from Liberia that are following and watching us want to say thank you. Thank you. And thank you so much for utilizing your data. Those of you listening to us on the radio, we'll say thank you for staying on the radio. Happy Father's Day. Let me say this to our gender here, especially the Adams gender, while we are with the Chairman Musa Bility, and Sekou that will be joining over. Let me say to our gender, let me say this to you. Gentlemen, I want time to shine. Yeah. Yeah, we got one. Oh, let me tell you something. We got one day the entire year. Today, our day. Don't let Eve General Honor mind this progress that we have made as father. It's not easy to be father. Look, it's not easy to be father. It's not easy to be father. I'm telling you. So we earn this thing, yeah. We gotta enjoy it. And your Eve General, y'all let up be great today. We're begging you. Y'all let up be great today. For God's sake, y'all let up be great for one. Hey, our own Sunday again, y'all overshadow. What is going on? Yes, I don't understand.
Let it put girl small chance, man. Let it get a chance. Yeah. Today, after the day now, it will until next year before the day comes.
If you're not careful, sir, all the entertainment spying today, instead of before our, it will be for our day. What is going on?
I tell you, the beauty about the people is that they don't make anything lazy. Yeah.
Our whole team, you gotta be funny enough for it.
They always want to be inside. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's the beauty of the people.
If you appreciate all today, you will not die. To the Eve gender, if you appreciate all today, you will not die. I want to wish one of my friends a happy birthday today, Abdullah Kiatama. Happy birthday. Abdullah Kiatama is one of the, I want to say, pioneers of SKTV. Abdullah Kiatama back in the days who call, interact with us here on SKTV. Happy birthday. Shout out to Abdullah Kiatama. Abdullah, wherever you are today, they are tired of tea on me, my brother. Coffee, everything. Yeah, it on me.
Take anything on you.
Take anything on me, brother.
Yeah.
Anything on me, Abdullah, it on me. Yeah, even if I credit, say, credit on me.
When I say pay, say,
put it on me. And we'll face it later. But what day today that we can credit anything, we'll take anything, nobody will say anything. On Monday, then they can report. But folks, we intend to have a very, very interesting conversation here today. A big national conversation. Normally, we'll restrict the conversation to CPP, Liberty Party, and so forth. But with the chairman today, we intend to have some serious, serious conversation. Very, very, very serious. That being said, I want to greet our folks from Liberia. Today is June 18th, 2023. The timestamp here in Phoenix, Arizona, it's 11:10 a.m. I believe on the East Coast today, it's 2:10 p.m. In the Midwest. I believe, let me see, it's 1:10 p.m. These guys are ahead of us 3 hours, Salomon, and we're in the same country.
Yeah.
And so this is amazing. These are some of the doings of God. But happy Father Day to us today. And if you're Eve gender, then y'all say happy Father Day today, you're not die. So y'all say happy Father Day for once. And we know say y'all that she ain't doing y'all to say happy Father Day, but you're just saying.
We're not proud, people. We're not proud.
I'm telling you.
Yeah.
I'm telling you. I don't understand. I tell
yeah,
you
when I'm busy.
Ego. Hello. I want to be ready. I got a fire again. Yeah. That to be right in the studio. To be first time coming today. Yeah.
Yeah.
The major happened just smiling all day. You got a phone.
Oh, Segu, that because of bad dream, or Steve, that because of bad dream, I've not sleep. Yeah, exactly. Not because they tell us happy Father Day, so I mean I'm not smart. No, you got to smart to put it down with a shame.
Yeah, you know, no. Let me tell you something. Let me just say this to you before we get into other news here, really quick. There's been lots of accusations made out there or thrown. We'll talk about we're getting to some of them. But look, let me say this. Let Toby just say. Oh, let me tell you to them, my people. What are y'all say happy Father Day now? We, the Iron Journal, we are chilling. Let me tell you, your happy Father Day waiting for to move. We move. In fact, we've been moved since the month started. Let me tell you to them. And we are watching y'all. Who never say happy Father Day? Who never wrote happy Father Day on your page? Next year, May. Any attempt to attempt next year, May. Yeah, and we see how don't be around what happened more day. Tobe, I'm telling you.
Me, are y'all observing you little by little?
You watching y'all?
Yes. Since the morning, I have been struggling, even when I was in church. I will call up my dad this morning and put it back on to see.
Exactly.
Who all are wishing us a happy Father Day. Yeah, because this day is so precious to us. Yeah, we can't make it lazy. You know what it takes for you to be a father?
I'm know telling what it you, is? The thing that we go through.
Y'all don't deny yourself a lot of things.
I'm telling you, the things
the
that
people don't want to know, the children don't want to know. They don't want to know. Steve, it's not easy to be a father.
You say, y'all see all passing the role, like, oh, the man, the father, they want to. My people, it come with a lot of stress and responsibility. Imagine you follow for the children or the child, then you follow again for the person who you get a child by. Then you father again for the whole, all your siblings, then you father. Then you turn around again, you probably father in the community. You turn around, you father the year in the church. What kind of trouble would take?
And guess what? your own car that you buy, you follow for it. Because I want an extra home there. You gotta feed it, you gotta feed it with gas every day when the tires fall. You have to do a lot of servicing on it.
Chief, help me say who. Help me say who, because when I say thank God, sir, like your first time being on the show working with all, you are Lord. Yeah, dude, look, let me tell you something. Y'all see how the Adam General, y'all see how we can even talk to each other about we, you see how we're team working together? You we see any other money ceremony? Yeah, all the money. So, you know, your even as we are here, look at Salomon, Panandua was speaking more today that Father Day. You expect the Eve General, all the money they're saving for the week, for the, you know, the nail polish and all the small stuff. Listen, you drop it in the cash out there to appreciate Father.
Mm-hmm. But you know what I mean? The people, they can be certified. God get in here, but they can still buy with car. They can still take all of at the future here, they added there. God get them fingernails, right? But they can buy all of at the future's fingernails. Yeah, they put very interesting. They are wonderful set of people.
Yeah.
Seriously.
So, I mean, I don't understand. And you know what? Why on SKTV, majority of the stakeholders in that women.
Mm.
Yeah.
I have not read it, Doman statistic.
My man, listen, we'll send it to nobody, but Melbourne need to be, you see the problem, Melbourne too focus on the wedding too, that you not share information. Yeah,
they may not share information. You know, marry that Jew.
Yeah, they may tell you what you here. We not tell you the
story. Is it Toby? You got to make it there. You got to go. The mother ray and Nana grabbing some, you know, technical issue.
My man, the man I spoke, I told the man, I said, my man, no poo Hakimi part two. The man said that's scared. The man ballon is struggle. And I know he's watching it right now. He's watching it from home.
They play right here now. I know he was on break.
The man ballon is struggle. Can you imagine? Adam Jenner. He allowed his Jenner to control him. And he get a ballon whole struggle.
The scene is happening in a garden. I want to have been a mebonso.
The guardian said, maybe why you need that day, you were confused. Adam was confused. But I'm talking about where Momo is alert and oriented.
In a kind of modern technology era.
I'm telling you. But either way, the man suddenly ran around the corner. So, you know, we'll do what we got to do. But folks, let's share the show. We're here with Salomon. Salomon, please give us a rundown of how the country is, what's going on, how's the Father Day celebration. And what's really happening? What's the feel in the country? How does it feel today? What's going on?
All right. Once again, thanks so much, Steve, for this platform. You know, when it comes to the atmosphere, we have a very conducive weather here in LRB. You know, this morning it started raining a bit, but since this evening and the rain have ceased and the weather very conducive that we can air this broadcast successfully. And when it comes to the Father Day, you know, it's actually been expressed on the social media. Yes, it's actually been expressed on the social media. You see everyone posting their dad or their relative one way or the other. But in terms of normal activity, everything are cool. It's not looking at a holiday, national holiday. No, you can only know that it is a Father Day through the social media. Yes. So Liberia is very cool. Everything going on normal. Yeah, in the political era.
Oh wow, everything is cool. Wow. Well, folks, those of you watching us, I beg you, today our Father Day, please let us be great. If the man tells you and go hang out with your friend, please don't be checking your phone, taking a car key. Don't bring no yo-yo today. That's public service announcement to your general. I beg you. Y'all let us, they were just turning the whole day. Now, why are y'all worried about us? Hello?
Yeah, I'm there, Steve. Okay. So, folks, if you're listening, this is SKTV. I'm here along with Steve on today's edition of this program, SKTV. Yeah. We coming to you live from the city of Pinsville outside Monrovia, Liberia on this 18th day of the 6 months in a year, AD 2023. And we have 18 minutes past the hour, 6 p.m. Yes, Steve?
Yes. Salomon, so thank you so much. Sorry, I got a call. We're trying to make connect here with the chairman. Like you said, it's raining in Labura. Well, let me say this to everybody. Let me say this to all of you folks. Welcome to the show. Welcome to this edition. The chairman will be on. There has been lots of accusation levied. We provide the chairman with ample time here today to clarify some things, provide context to the conversation today. And we'll try not to interrupt the chairman as much as we can. But again, we have CPP politics. Unfortunately, the former president has been, I don't want to use the word direct, but she's been brought into the conversation as evidenced by the interview that was held by Senator Darius Taylor on another platform yesterday. Those things will be discussed here today. We don't want any surprise or surprises to you, our listeners and our viewers. So gear yourself up. The conversation promises to be very, very interesting today. We are going to go a little deeper into this conversation. It's going to not only be national, local politics conversation internationally. We are going to talk about some things that are at play here and the risk the country is in. We're going to talk about the country. We're going to talk about everything. Don't mind the father day thing that we're discussing. It's still important to us as well. Because today you all need to free the let me tell you something. Your if generally you need to free up. Without going to make no one, you're free up. You get something. All that time faith today, you forget about it today. Yeah, you forget about the time faith. Tomorrow that Monday, you can tie a faith from Monday to Friday when I get problem now. Today. Especially today when my board ain't getting ready to go chill right now. So many I know they're putting themselves together. Get it easy, bro. Don't bring noise in the town. We're not calling. Even Patrick Tulu said, we're not answering the phone. We're not bringing no noise in the town. Yeah, you're just what it got.
That's what you're talking about, sir.
Yeah, but you're going to let us sleep. He's scrolling on Facebook, go to the castle, show them your something. Today, we're not on our way to go. We're not on it with you. I'm speaking on behalf of the Adam gender. All my men who are watching me, who are listening to me, gentlemen, are not betraying the struggle. I will be in the struggle. Tonight, you're going to chill. To never go chill. Even if you are men of God, say you have call, you won't go chill. Go chill. No wala.
No, but men of God can chill. Men of God can chill. Yeah, Steve, men of God can chill. Yeah, they can chill. Yeah, but you can go to the conducive area. Yeah, you can go there to the hard plastic area. They stress too much.
Being a father that too much stress by itself, too much responsibility. For the men said to go to someone to play, just sit down to play. I said, remember my dream. So check play.
Yeah.
Your body on your time, your face, you want to take khaki, you want to lie to the McCoy, the community chairman. Without even the community chairman said I'm available today in which you.
And I'm working you.
Exactly.
Nothing working. Let it change your plan. Yeah, nothing working.
Tomorrow any complaint you get will resume the complaint. We're saying it to you. So your behave tonight, you put your life together. Your behave tonight, your eat generally, your behave. If your MPA will pull the hacking on you again, we're not here for that thing. But anyway, folks, thank you so much for joining us today. We'll get to the musical break really quick. But in other news, there's been a lot of things going on. A lot of things going on. Yesterday we said it, President Donald Trump, some serious charges levied against him. Here he's indicted in the United States. Very, very serious. There's even been some concern. This morning I was listening to his what we have in Liberia as the minister of defense, the former minister of
defense ministry,
exactly. They call him the secretary of defense. They call him the secretary of defense, and he says some very, you know, very serious things. He's concerned about the allegations or what's alleged in the charges for former president Donald Trump. It is very, very serious, very, very, very serious, and so, you know, from the look of things, President Donald Trump is now, he's really not in a good situation. But amidst that, Solomon, it will shock you to know that President Donald Trump still has two more indictments awaiting him, such as the January 6th protest that was held, or rally, or whatever you want to term it as, that was held at the Capitol building. Yeah, he's not even been charged or indicted on that yet. He's only been indicted on the documents that he took and kept with him as presidential record or whatever it is. So, and then you also have another case that is pending indictment in Atlanta, Georgia, where he's on tape, asking the governor to commit crimes in Atlanta, Georgia, to get votes for him. So these are concerning allegations. But other parts of the world, Sierra Leone is gearing up for her elections. We're following very closely. Sierra Leone is a neighbor to us over there, and so we wish them the best. We pray and wish them, you know, peace, transparency, and so forth in the election. We pray it be not void of violence. Julia Maada Bello, who's the sitting president, wants to go for a second term. That's not uncommon for African presidents or leaders or other leaders around the world. Even in the country, we have Joe Biden, who is still, you know, who still wants to run. You know, so we wish them well, because we got to pray for our neighbors, you know, as well. Guinea also seemed to be on a serious, we're following up with Guinea. Guinea seemed to be on a serious momentum as well. The junta leader, the junta leader who took over, you know, after the coup of the sitting president, he seemed to be gaining steam, likeness and momentum amongst his people. There seemed to be calmness in Guinea. And so we want to say thank God for that. Our neighboring country, Ivory Coast, our state, very long time, has some serious ties and relationship there. We want to say kudos to them. They are hosting the African Cup of Nations next year. Don't be surprised, Toby. Don't be surprised, Salomon, my man. When we chauffeur to the town, we decide to go to
Africa
again. Yeah, you know, and we come back in our asset mimosa Jesse. And So. Asset mimosa in Africa is the equivalent of RE in Liberia. And then Africa sports in Africa is the equivalent of Mate Barrow in Liberia. So don't be surprised if you see me in my Asset Mimosa t-shirt or my Asset Mimosa jersey and I show you on SKD. Don't be confused at me. But
I think I was gonna catch you there, because my Umba, I'll just take it by Nima Kande right there.
Yeah, No. Once we cross by that time. Hopefully Chairman Bility, you know, they have won the election and he's in the house. Ask them, we appeal to the representative, the House of Representatives, to close the border.
You want me to leave Liberia too?
No, you
want me to be here all day.
You're looking like you get betrayed struggle, so we'll leave your
I'm friend. Looking at Mabon. I'm looking at Mabon.
No, we're out to test you. But anyway, folks, quickly to Liberia. A lot of things are happening. Lots of endorsements going on. Lots of things are happening. And lots of revelations, lots of infights are happening. Don't be surprised this week. If you hear some more noise, the whole country just in yo-yo right now. The whole country in yo-yo. Everybody just posing, everybody just talking. But I want to send out a serious shout out or caveat to the opposition before we get to the musical break. If you're an opposition member and you took money from the government, I want you to know that your video will come out, your recording will come out. You might remember today, Father Day. That includes some of you talking plenty, making all the noise. You might rather show that we have reviewed your video and listened to it. We know what they on there. We know what they on there. And your video will come out. You will hear yourself talking. Your recording, you will check. The government, let me tell you something. You can say the government is corrupt. You can say the government is inept. You can say the government is incompetent. But you can't say the government is stupid. And not you. No boys put you on record. You will see. Your children will hear you talking. You will know. You will know. So there will be a lot of, you know, just for the Father, as part of the Father Day gift, we want to give to our brother there who betrayed the struggle. There will be a lot of you will receive gifts, the Father Day gifts. Your recording there will just be surfacing all over the place. Whether you want to deny or not, business, your voice there, and you are collecting bribe, you are taking money, you are corrupt. So just watch out for that. But the noise will not cease, just so you know, the noise will not cease. It will even intensify. There will be noise outside of the country. Will be noise. There will be a lot of exposure. But at this point, everybody is trying to make the case of change to the Liberian people.
Yeah.
And if you are making a case for change and you have gone and undermined the interests of the Liberian people, well, we can consider you as change agent. Don't be surprised when your political leader there show fail. Don't be surprised.
But Steve, from my own little man analysis, is that what I've actually learned, you know, there is no actual coordination among the leaders. So at the end of the day, when that coordination will not exist, you always hear noise. Yeah. You know, in a home, it's just looking at in a home, mother pushing different idea while the father pushing another idea. You know, but when they are concurring with one another, coming up with a specific idea, there will be no noise. But everybody, they are seeking their interest. So for me, I would not be surprised that the noise that will be here and there, every now and then. Yeah. Moreover, that's the beauty of politics. Yeah. All I want, it makes politics very unique.
Yes, definitely. So but as we're with the chairman, it makes politics really, really unique. I agree with you. And we have lots of revelations. It's not uncommon in politics, just so you know. It is not. A lot of secrets will come out, a lot of betrayals. People that you didn't expect to do certain things, they will do it. Say certain things, they will say it. But hey, this is part of the nature of the politics we've cultivated in our society. And don't think it will change overnight, Anacho. It will not change overnight because we are dealing with deceptive people who don't trust each other. And so they will go at any length, at any risk, and at any depth to ensure that they undermine, throw each other in the bus for their own gains. So I'm not shocked. We look forward to more of these. And, you know, some people right now, they're jittery and they're, you know, they're confused. Some BBT and I, they toss some BBT in your acting like this. Don't get ready to anxiety. And I mean, yeah. My man, toss some, there's some deep things, some big betrayals that happen.
Steve, you know, when a fire about to catch, it can start with the smoke, then from there, a small heat before it go to the actual heat. And, you know, so we just starting, the fire just catching.
Yes, it is. The fire just started. And folks, let's turn up quick to the musical break here while we are with our guest, the chairman. He did tell us that he will be late. He will be running late here. We're informed. So let's get to the musical break really quick. We'll be right back. Find a friend like me. Happy Father's Day to us as fathers.
Yes.
Yeah. But we'll be right back. As Melbourne would say, don't you dare change the dial. Don't you try it. But let's find a friend. Yeah.
Find a friend like me. If you not want betray, find a friend like me. Find a friend like me. If you not want betray, find a friend like me.
Bombe o. Fire a friend, let me. Fire a friend, let me. Fire a friend, let me. Fire a friend, let me.
Hey, see bestie. Your bestie not sweet like my bestie. Your bestie not la la bestie. Fire a friend, let me.
I say, see bestie. Bestie won't tend to wealthy.
Find a friend, let me.
okoro, 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 okoro. They won't step on my blessing, but God gonna break it, yeah. Okoro, they won't call it my blessing, but God gonna break it, yeah. Okoro,
Frenchie, see Frenchie, can't see Papa T Frenchie. I don't want no bad for Frenchie.
I don't want no wedding to happen.
Wangolo, 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 eh, Wangolo. Wango for bestie, Wangolo, Wango for daddy, Wangolo.
I hear them say, they want me go, they want me go. I say, eh, eh. They want me go, I say, eh, eh.
Well, folks, thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, and thank you. This song, yeah, whether you like this song or not, whether you believe in this song or not, this song got its own momentum. This song got its own momentum. This song not easy. This song not easy, the way we can say in that, bro. Well, sick folks, sick will be joining us in a moment here as we gear for the conversation here. We were up very, very late last night. Very late. When I say very late, very, very late. For those of you on the East Coast, just imagine we were up until 5, 6 p.m. your time. And to take the prelude for the Father Day celebration. So we're up to 2, 3, me and Seku. That was, it was not so much chilling. But Mr. Kane, welcome to the show. What is going on?
I'm okay. Solomon, how you doing?
Oh, wonderful. Thank you. Thank you for the recognition. Yeah, it's been a while.
It's been a minute.
I run.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, that's good.
Yeah, but Mr. Kane, what is going on? Happy Father Day to you. Why are you just king with the Father Day? You just put your face in full. So what is going on? Oh, your Father Day, when you were dancing last night, I'm going to tell you to put a dance move there. I'm going to show you in the video. What is going on?
Yeah, I'm all right. The chairman was kind of running late. Yeah, but he touched me that he was going to be here in the last 5 minutes.
Okay.
So that means he should be on anytime for now. Yeah. But let me make sure I'll be right back.
Okay, Seku will be right back. Seku will be right back, folks. Last night, it was not the LeBron who can say it was not easy. Solomon?
Yes, I know. So, you tell us about the occasion. What occasion are you about? It was not easy.
No, Megeto.
Megeto, eh?
Yeah,
but yeah, secret accounts out.
Oh, need that team. We were. Need that team. Need that other one. Need that other one. It was. We're also last night bigly. Well, I don't know what to say. We're also bigly last night.
Wow.
Yeah. My man from wedding, mm-hmm. We went again to the chilling spa, to the entire chilling spa with chilling.
So you did a pre-celebration already for the Father Day?
That thing, brother. We're not eating Nisa on all the Father Day.
Yeah. <That'd be weird.
laughs> What is it, my man? Let me tell you something. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Like you said today, there's nothing we can do as fathers. We just need to enjoy ourselves because I was stressed too much. So last night we enjoy ourselves. Mommy, we're up to 6 a.m. Can you imagine?
But Steve, too much of everything ain't good to all. Yeah.
Man, nothing. Sonny got to get off. So long, I healthy chilling. That is. But what else? Hmm. What then? were there, we connected with some people from Liberia, they saw us chilling, some people from Minnesota, some of our board and they jealous. Oh, my man, what do you we say your leader thing? It was not easy last night. But I didn't know, say we can dance. I want to hide it from you. Say we can get that again. Oh, they never dancing. I mean, talking it. Make it talk about.
I will not because you are saying that you want to show a video that it may, you know, take that sabbatical break.
No, we can show that video for security reasons. Yeah, we got a position in man. Man was easy good last year. You
know? I think yeah. They now feel with the Holy Spirit.
We'll be men actually, they won't begin actually.
Yeah.
Anyways, folks, the chairman is almost here, getting ready. Today, like I said, a big conversation we're having. Big conversation. We are here with Chairman Musa Bility, and we will make sure that Chairman Musa Bility has ample time to speak to the issues. Mr. Kane, we're not hearing you.
I said, look at this chairman like eating billion, eh?
No, the chairman.
I can see the chairman through a mouth.
The father, they're chilling now.
They've been celebrating the father there, eh?
Yeah. Amen. Mr. Kane, I'll need to. Take over for a second. Let me fix something here really quick on my camera.
I got you.
All right.
Mr. Chairman, how are you, sir?
I'm okay. You know, it's Sunday. So, but we are still working because we need to fix the country. So, no holiday.
So, you good to go? I know you're running away.
Yeah, sorry. You know, in the Cinco area, there is an outage of the Liptiapo network. I'm told that there was some damage done to it, so I have to use other engineers to be here, you know, this evening. So, but I'm happy I'm here, you know, as usual.
Okay. Good to see you.
Thank you.
As always, you look excited. And I believe, you know, everything's going good with you and the CPP. So how are you and the family, by the way, before we jump into politics?
Oh, the family is good. Today was a good day for me. My kids reached out to me. You know, you feel good. If you are a good father, responsible father, and you feel, you know that you play a part, you know, in your children's life, you feel good to be called a good father. So, you know, so it was a good day. But like I said, we are on the go. I remember I was close to a former general of the U.S. Army. He and I were very close. We always used to sit down and lecture. Calling General, yes, I'm sure you remember him. He used to be the head of ITC Bank right after 1994. He said, when you are leading a war, you can't look back because all of your army are looking at you. The moment you look back, they begin to feel that you are faltering. So for me, I've taken a vehicle. I'm in a vehicle, and that vehicle is marching to the executive mansion. It has no reverse. There's no way to turn around. And we have no one way to go. Because honestly, Sibu, that is the only way for this country.
All right. Thank you. Thank you so much. So folks, I want to welcome each and every one of you to SKTV once again. I know Steve was here and Solomon was also here. I believe they have done that already. But yes, it is great to be here. The chairman of the Collaborating Political Party, Chairman Musa Hassan Bility, is here. And we want to take this time to say happy Father's Day to all of the great fathers out there, not the irresponsible fathers, not the one that don't, you know.
Exactly.
They don't pay attention to the kids, they don't even take care of the kids. The one that I ran away from their wife until 17 years later, they can't sanction me, the kid that knows not the father I'm talking about. took my responsible father that take care of the home, the family. Because also being a father is not only about, you know, taking care of your wife, your kids, and your wife, and all the family. It's very, very important. So I want to encourage each and every one of you to share the show today. Because you know what? When it's Musa Bility, you know there will be a lot of revelations. And the chairman is a newsmaker, trust me. And whenever he's poised to go somewhere, you know, the turnout can be huge. So before we start the show, I just want to announce that one of the great fans of the SKTV sent us $100 and said that $25 for Mabel, $25 for Abraham. Can you imagine? She's not only supporting SKTV, but she knows most of our reporters back in Liberia. And on the personal level, she take care of them sometimes. But she sent $100 today, saying that $100, $25 for Abraham, for the father, for Mabel, and then $50 for SKTV. So Steve, I want to say thank you to that person. I'm not sure if I'm permitted to call name, because I didn't see anything call my name or don't call my name. I want to say thank you to that person. So Chairman, whose ability? Are you in Monrovia right now?
Yes.
Okay, so let's jump into the conversation. We saw you in Banga yesterday. How was it? And what's going on?
Well, Sibu, you know, sometimes when I'm on air, it's like sometimes I sound too combative, but that's my nature. Sometimes I sound too self-assured. That's my nature. But I told you that the decision to put Mr. Cumming as a candidate to be president of Liberia is resonating. Bon Kande yesterday says a lot of things. I say, well, let me tell you what Bon Kande is particularly important or significant. Bon Kande was, until the arrival of Senator Yala, Bon Kande was one of the countries where we knew that we had not done a lot. You know, what you saw yesterday is the outcome of maybe 2 weeks, or 2 months or 6 weeks, a very robust, can be attributed by a former sitting senator. And so it is the way Bon Kande show up is how the country is going to show up. We're excited. We are ready for this campaign. And Tegu, I say it. The people that you don't know, the people that don't come on Facebook and insult one another, the people that are not calling on the radio, they just go and listen to the radio or watch you and I. They, based on polling, they represent at least 45% of those who have voting cards in their hands. And we only make a decision that is right for Liberia. And you will see it. Every now and then, what we have done to ourselves, and I think we are at fault from the beginning. We try to split this campaign into two categories of political parties. We say opposition and government. No. Cebu, the campaign is divided not only into three directions, but into three categories. We have the ruling party. We have the opposition parties. And we have the former ruling party.
Okay.
And that division is only coming onto us. But it has been there. And for instance, the United Party has made that very clear. In every way he has acted. In the CPP, it concluded that unless it is given the standard bearership, there will be no CPP because they are former ruling party. They are bigger, more experienced. No matter what that experience is, but that was their position. Today, the United Party has now gone into any collaboration with any political party simply because it has established itself as a category standing by itself as a former ruling party, and therefore it does not feel that it is like or equal to any other opposition party. So it's the direction that is the election that we're facing right now also had three choices in that very line. The choice of yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Over 65% of Liberians, 65% of Liberians that have voting card in their hand have voted before. Therefore, they have a history of the United Party and the CDC. And they will make a decision that will not sound redundant to their life. So the thing that we are missing is a very effective propaganda machine of the United Party, a very deficient propaganda machine of the CDC, fighting the CPP. And I'll give you the reason. Effective because the United Party, for instance, when we have rallies and there are too many people there, you see there are minions, I don't call them soldiers, there are minions, coming to say we truck people. So then you behave as though this is a senatorial or representative election. Or are we talking Guineans or Ivorians? If we drop people from Morovia, what does that say to you? We got people in Morovia. If we drop people from Nimba, what does that say to you? We got people in Nimba. If they go somewhere and a few hundred people show up, they say human magnet. So could they see when you were surprised yesterday? Now you'll be surprised election day. You know, I saw your cameraman, in fact, he interviewed me. You saw people hanging on the trucks coming from the villages. Amen, Segu. The men who hang on that truck, risk their life on that quota to come stand in the sun. That man will not take 10 minutes to go vote for that same person.
They will.
That is sitting there. Hey, you need to buy everything down there. K campaigning in Mosowaru campaign is decided. I'm gonna tell them, Mosowaru campaign is decided. They are the people that you and myself speak to every day. Campaigning, rallying in Mosowaru has no value. Tegu have been in it since 2005. It brings nothing to you, and they know that. So let us sit down. I'm just laughing. But in any case, I'm happy. Because the CPP is going to win this election. We know that we will go in the second round with the CDC. And we know that those who did not vote for the CDC in the first round will not vote for the CDC in the second round. And therefore, they will vote for us. And we will win the election. So we are happy. I'm relaxed. I will soon be called the ruling party chairman. That comes with a bigger responsibility. I look up to, you know, retaining the CPP. I look up to building a party that is self-sufficient in around the country, involving agricultural activity. I look up to building an army of partisans that will be involving other things, self-help, income generating activity across the country.
Chairman, thank you so much.
Thank you
so much. And now I want to ask you about this, and I want you to really explain to people. Some people say you are running away for Ellen's support. Some people say, oh no, this one happened, that one happened. And that was DeLong, the senator of Mosowaru County, gave a narrative yesterday as to what really transpired with him, you, and the former president, Ellen Johnson Sirleaf. Can you give us a clear picture of what really happened?
You know, Sego, first, I want to say thank you because it's on my chest. So before I focus on the reason why I'm here, I need to get it out. It'll take me a bit. Let me try to. You know, Sego, DeLong is a wicked human being. He's diabolical. And in the process, he's ignorant and arrogant. The meeting that they don't talk about, it did take place. But let me tell you what happened before that meeting. What happened before the meeting? What hurt me that want me to respond to this is that it is DeLong that pulled Ellen into that meeting.
Say that again.
It is Darryl DeLong that pulled Ellen Johnson Sirleaf into that meeting. Sego, I want to go back because it's important to go back before I come to answer the question. While the Liberty Party case was at the Supreme Court, the case was called, and so the parties went to court. I got to court late. When I got there, Councillor Charlene Bromstein was there, DeLong was there, our Vice Chair for Political Affairs was there, Secretary General, the Vice Chair of Administration, all of our people were there, Young Lee was there, and DeLong was there. And there were seats between, and Moriah, where I went there. And I sat back, you know, while waiting for the justices to come. And I said, Delon, why are we allowing the court to force us into settlement? Why can't we sit down and come? Why can't we talk so that whatever the court decides, we would have already passed over that hurdle? Why? Then he said, I think so. He said, I think so. Then I said, if you think so, why can't we do it? He said, anyway, let's hear what the court say. Oh God, I hear myself talk. I said, Taylor, I beg you. It's not okay. Then the court, the justices, you know, when the justices, they are coming in, you know, the normal procedure all right, and the justices giving in, and then they keep just announced that one of the justices, Justice Wolokoli, could not be present that morning, and she would like to sit on that case. So therefore, we have to postpone, and the court will inform us when will be the next date. So our case was not heard on that day. And we walked down. When we walked down, I went to Dillon. I said, Dillon, the thing you were talking, okay. Then Dillon said, my man, get in my car. At that time, Wadi and the entire Liberty Party crew were upstairs because I think they were waiting for the lift. And then I'm sure Dillon and I were the first that got in the lift, so the lift brought us down. Dillon said, my man, get in my car. Let's go. Let's go talk. That was Dillon. Guy in Darren Dillon's car. We drove from the Temple of Justice to the Capitol building. When we reached the Capitol building, I told him, pull your driver down. But I'm not going to your office. I'm all the talk in the car. So finish then you can me back. Because my folks were waiting for me. If I remember that day, why they were calling me, upset with me, where you left? I said, I'm coming back. Dillon said, my man, we need to solve the problem. Then I said, Dillon, what do you want? Dillon said to me, Musa, the only solution, because these United Party people, they are arrogant and ungrateful. And I want to, excuse me for my word, I will not use it, but I'll just say, I want to F with them.
Who said that, Dillon?
Darius Dillon. And I want to show to them, because it's clear to us, at that time, it was clear to Dillon then that Ambassador Boga was not going to pick them. And he said, if we can make a decision so that we can announce it before they announce their decision, they will break them. This is Dillon talking to me. In his car, in Darius Dillon's car. Then I said, Dillon, they asked me, said, Musa, you know, whether you are a Muslim, whether you are a Christian, we all serve the same God. And I know what I'm talking. It was Darius Dillon, it was me, and the only other witness was the God that we both said. And he said, Musa, are you able to make Alex coming to choose Yomli as running mate? Then I said, you know, you are behind time. Last year, around November, Ambassador Louis Brown, Jacob Smith, Nyombri Kanga Lawrence, and myself met in Louis Brown house. To reconcile the Liberty Party. At that meeting, I said to Yomli, the reason why I have refused to come with you is because Liberty Party is too big an institution for you to drag behind you to go to Unity Party without any agreement. There is nothing that says that Joseph Waga will pick you. He has not made a commitment to the party. He has not made a commitment. But normally, if Joseph Waga pick you, if Joseph Waga call us in this forum with you, Louis Brown, Jacob Smith, and the witnesses, Jacob Julius Smith was in that meeting. If Joseph Boga commits to choosing you as his running mate, I will surrender the Liberty Party. We will surrender. That will be the end of the conflict. If we don't accept that ticket, we'll go our individual way. But that will be the end of the Liberty Party conflict. Then Louis Brown said, Musa, are you also in a position to ask Alice Cummings if he is amenable to carrying Yomli as his running mate? So that while Yomli goes to ask Bwaga whether he's prepared to make this commitment, you go to Cummings to ask him whether he's prepared to take Yomli.
And this is when? What year? Oh, what
November 2022.
Last year, 2022. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
So I said, that's fine. And then he said, if the two of them say yes, then what? Then I say, we will go the Unity Party way because that's the place we want to be. Simple. That was the end of the meeting. And Yomli was to go and make and speak to Bwaga and come back and get us to go and ask Bwaga. Because I said, there's no way that you will want to take the party to Bwaga and stay in the window, in the wind as to whether or not he's going to choose you. I said, that's not Liberty Party. So we left that day. God knows, in one of those meetings, to prove to you, we were sitting in the meeting, this very meeting I'm telling you about, which nobody had heard about. Jacob Smith's daughter had an accident on a motorbike. And Jacob had to leave. He said, oh, I just have an accident. I'm just trying to connect things that happened to the meeting, during the meeting, and we adjourned the meeting. In that meeting, I said to Yomli that it is about you as political leader and me as chairman agreeing, but bringing all your Nyama people, bringing Dino and all these people, now Dino is a spoiler. I said that to her. I said, if Dino had not been between you and I, would not have had what you want. It's not what I want. We'll never have, there's no conflict in our desires. That's what I told her. She left. Somebody was feeling good that day. She left with a good feeling. I remember the next day was, I think, you know, Jerry Robert birthday or talk about birthday, because I think the 30th is one of the president's birthday. And normally, I know it was holiday, and normally send me, for the first time in a very long time, she sent me a holiday greeting. Because they talk had a 2-week break, and we'll come back down to see what Cummings say and to see what Barker say. When they left, Louis Brown said to me, and said, Musa, I said, yeah. I said, do you know what you're doing? I said, yes, Louis. I'm tired. If I don't want Barker, I can go individually and go and support. You know, I don't have to be a member of the party, but if this will bring the party together, that's fine. Because to support the main candidate in the party, you have to resign from the party because it's illegal. So I said, no problem, I will do that. If this is what will bring the party together, but I cannot commit the party to Joseph Barker when Joseph Barker has not committed to the party. Louis Brown said, okay. I said, Louis, I want you to take me to Alex Cummings. He said, I want you to mark this question down so that the day Alex Cummings appear on the show, you ask him. You do that for me as a favor. Steve, please.
Steve,
so you can ask him whether I brought Louis and I met him, Ambassador Louis Brown. Our current campaign manager, who is literally turning everything around. Louis said, okay, I will take you. I call Alex. I said, Alex, I need to see you. But I'm coming with Louis. We set an appointment. We went to Alex's house. I said, Alex, I think I have an opportunity to solve the Liberty Party problem. I need your help. No, I've been there. I'm very loyal to you. I will remain loyal to you because I believe that you mean well to the country. But at this time, I want to remember, can you commit to carry Yombly as your running mate? And then that will end the Liberty Party crisis. Remember now, and then we told him that we have asked Yombly to ask Barker if we can say the same thing. So just in case Barker say yes, Yombly will be going with Barker and Liberty Party will be going with Yombly. I told Alex coming down. And Alex said, yes, Musa, Liberty Party has stood with me. If there's anything I can do to make sure that the party stay together, I will do it. Absolutely. That was the end of the meeting. We went on to other team, stayed there. I think that day we watched football game, and that was it. So we set the date for the second meeting. This was a meeting now where Yombly was to come to tell us what was the outcome of our meeting with Joseph Barker. Mm-hmm. So that I would tell her what was the outcome of my meeting with Alex Cummings. And we had agreed that if Barker says no and Cummings says yes, we go with Cummings. We guess where we had this meeting. The first meeting was Louis Brown House. The second meeting was in Yombly House on the old road. Nobody knew about this. I never informed anybody.
Wow.
I made personal effort to bring peace to Liberty Party. Louis Brown and I went to Yombly House. Sada, Uncle, right outside there, she brought water, drank. Yombly was there. Jacob Smith was there. And then say, we are here. And I said, okay. I met Mr. Cummings, and Mr. Cummings says, we should be assured that if that's what he has to do to put 1 hour together, he would do it. And then Yobli said, you know, I thought about it, and this thing is not about me alone. Whatever I discuss, they don't have to be there. Other people have to be there. I said, what? Then I said, Luis, for me, at least I made an effort. But it clear to me that you don't need no more peace in the party. How? So you see where I have taken it, right? From Diloka to laying the premise and then going back to Dillon. So and I tell Dillon, I said, Dillon, you are asking me whether I'm able to make, to ask Alex to choose Yombi. This is the long road they took. And that is already an offering. So don't Alex, you don't know about it. It is possible. Then they don't look in my face, I swear to my God, and say, Musa, let's do this. Let's do it now. A few weeks later, Chairman Ben Sandy arrived. I said, Ben, let's go talk to him. Of course, after Ben arrived, then Joseph Baga had made his decision. Dillon was despondent. I bring Ben on everything. And then Ben said, what do we do? I said, let's call the man. You know, nobody say, if it's not Dillon, she can't say anything. So, hey, if you want to talk to Yombi, you got to Dillon, so let's go to Dillon. Man, we need to solve this problem. This is 8:30 in the night. Again, another personal attempt. We call Dillon. Dillon say, "Ah, oh, y'all want to see me? Y'all come to my house." Banavi. I finished forgetting my house there. Because when you were becoming senator, you told us, hey, you will not build house. When you go to Dillon, you will not defend. You can't even see the house again. So we end up, we're in a small building on the side. We were there, the whole table, we were smoking, drinking, frustrated on the whole decision about. That night, we said, Dillon, let's do this. So Dillon said, my man, I don't trust the situation. What is Ellen position? We are coming back to Ellen now. Where is Ellen position? I said, what are you talking? What do you mean, what is Ellen position? Because I need a guarantor so that when we make a peace between us, we need somebody to go, I want Ellen involved. Darius Dillon is the one who insisted that Ellen should be involved. Dillon is wicked. Then I said, okay, if this is what we need, again, remember now, this is all in Liberty Party situation. Gentlemen, I told Ben, I said, Ben, you know, this is what Dillon said, so we'll talk to the president to reach out to him so that I can recall Ellen saying, I don't want, if this had anything to do with politics, I don't want anything to do. If that to talk between you, I got no problem. I swear to God. Dillon was called, and he called me to confirm that he was called. And he went to meet him. I attended that meeting. And yes, Alex Cumming attended the meeting. But here is the difference between me and Darius Taylor. When you sit with a former president of the country, and of course, she and Dylan had a meeting like 30 minutes or so before, you know, I me around. And you come on national television. Not only you disclose that, but you lie about that. So it is bad. It's very bad. I would not. And I'm sure at the appropriate time, the former president will respond to Dylan. I'm very sure of that. And I'm not at liberty. And this is the cardinal rule of individual privacy. To say to the public what was in the meeting I was called, which Dylan requested for. I will not do that. The reason why I will not do that, because Tegu, today, answer yesterday, today I met a very prominent person. And the person told me, say, you know, during your classes, Dylan reached to somebody to reach to me so that I can intervene. And I told the person, I don't trust Dylan. And so when I heard him last night telling the public what he was called privately to discuss, and not only that, lie, it hurt me. People will hear me. He was not called by any Dylan. Benjamin Sambi is my witness. Ask us that if we want to make peace with Yombly, and there must be guarantor, because Yombly has literally surrendered her position or role to Dylan. So she told me in a meeting with Louis Brown that anything that she do, Dylan will be involved. That's why I went to Dylan. And so, say, go. We're in trouble. In America, because senators, they disclose national security information to them. There are people in this town that you sit down with. And I want to tell the folks from the Unity Party, you're very friendly with Dylan today. Dylan was very, very friendly with Benjamin Uribe. Dylan was very, very friendly with Ellen Johnson Sirleaf. Dylan was extremely close to George Weah. Today, I remember when George Weah graduated from college, that Dylan then was celebrating that graduation. Maybe some of you don't know that. Today, all those people, Dylan sits in the public to discuss one thing or another. Without a tartan, where the air coming from between the teeth, everything he started to say with SS in it, just lie on people. It is dangerous. That particular politician, I've made a promise to myself. He and my dad will not sit down on the same political table. He now worth it. He is a liar. He is arrogant in his lying. And he's deceitful. And he's self-serving. And let me explain to you what is responsible for some of these things. When you have limitation academically, when your knowledge is absent, then your only focus becomes yourself.
Because Sekou, this, when you have position like he has, is the only security he has. Just take Jerome from Senegal today. He not qualify for any job. He cannot use a CV to do anything with it. So he keeps himself in those positions, and everything he does is self-serving. I want you in the party to remember that Dylan came to me to say we must mess with Joseph Baga. Everything you're doing with Dylan, I just want you to know that there's a dark side that you are not showing to you. Hey, we don't agree politically, and I'm scared of you. I will fight you on the last day. We are after the same thing, either you win or we win. So it got nothing to do with the law. But one thing that is important is that if I walk in the room today where I see Ambassador Joseph Baga, I'll walk to him and shake his hand. I call him my uncle, and he will shake my hand. Because you know what? Beyond politics, I will never hurt him or hurt his person or betray his confidence. I've had very close relationship with Joseph Baga. Very confidential relationship with Joseph Baga. Nothing. No amount of politics. Just as he, Joseph Baga, has never mentioned that. No amount of politics will make me to disclose the extent and the nature of my relationship with him. That's not Dylan. He doesn't care. Because he has no capacity to do anything except, you know, when your brain is empty, what you have, you hold on to that. A friend of mine told me that today, and I really, really believe that. So, hey, guys, thank you for giving me the chance. Thank you for giving me the chance to explain the story about Darius Dylan and this so-called meeting with Ellie, and Ellie supporting Cummings. And then maybe Dylan set it up so that he can use it the way he's using it. But Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, the former president of Liberia, did not call a mediatory meeting. Darius Dylan requested her to intervene to mediate between the Liberty Party case. That's what happened.
So, Mr. Chairman, thank you so much for that deliberation. Before I go to Steve, I want to ask you this question about Senator Dylan. Dylan is boasting that he is a kingmaker of most of the country, that he can make Joseph Baga president. You have participated in several elections and campaign. Given what you know today, do you think Dylan has any leverage to change anything in Masuado?
Sebu, Darius Dylan ran for Senate before. You don't remember that. He never even got 10,000 votes. He ran for Senate before. You don't remember that. You know, I got 10,000 votes. The United Party, the ALP, the ANC, and the Liberty Party joined together to take that seat. That is number two, number three, number four parties in the 2017 election in Masuado. Join it together. How you gonna win? How you gonna win? But you know, Sekou, and we are now. Tana, and citizens are used to behave, just to say they now win. And we have an election now. And election coming, the same way they don't time will come. He has zero. And he's not in the United Party with good faith. He has zero leverage.
Steve, back to you. We're not hearing you. I think you're muted.
Thank you, Sekou, and welcome, Chairman Bility. Happy Father Day to you.
Thank you.
I've listened to your deliberation so far based on the mention of your name and Mr. Legend B. Cummings and the former president. Here's my question to you.
I don't know, Steve. For some reason we are hearing some background noise. I don't know where it's coming from.
Yeah, somebody either the Steve.
I think we need to maybe you know mute everybody when we read to 13 from the chairman, sir, maybe.
No, I don't think from the chairman, I think from the studio.
It's not from me.
It's from the studio, the feedback from the studio.
But I already muted the guy.
Yeah, we can't hear it. That's what I'm saying. It's from the studio.
Okay. It's okay now. I muted the studio, so let's go.
Yeah, okay, so try and see.
All right, we're better now. We're much better. Thank you. So no, we're still getting it back.
Okay, I muted him. Go ahead.
Great. So Chairman Bility, my first question is, do you know
this coming from your end too, or maybe
who?
What's going on? Why, Mr. Chairman, can you hear us clearly?
Yeah, very clear.
All right, go ahead, Steve.
Do you know President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf?
Very well. Very, very well.
Very, very well. If so, there are many young voters. There are many young people. We've heard the CD, the Unity Party. We've heard the Unity Party used President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf as a campaign tool or as a campaign message to elevate themselves through their surrogates, through some of the leaders, the partisans who want to distance themselves from her, and so forth. My question to you is, what can you say in summary? Who is President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf? Because we have lots of young voters. Who is President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf?
President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf is the first elected female president of the African continent. President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf is the first female president of the Republic of Liberia. For 12 years. President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf is a president I was close to, served in her government in minimum role like chairman of the board 2 times, a close political advisor, a close ally, very, very proud of her achievement as president of the Republic of Liberia, know exactly where the country was and where she brought us to. Knowing that the country is a journey, she brought us to a place where we were ripe enough to move on. President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf is the one bright spot in our country as far as the international community is concerned. Just as during the war, if you recall, George Weah was the only bright spot in our country. When we travel during the war, you go to anywhere in Europe, anywhere. Oh, where are you from? I'm from Liberia. Oh, George Weah. That's what Ellen is today. The war at those hall, women around the world at those hall, and Steve, I'm very, very proud. I came on the CPP, I'm craving for her to get out of retirement and come and endorse the CPP. I'm praying for it. Let the Honorable go and be, I'm praying for it.
Thank you, Chairman.
So yes, I'm a proud
proud associate of Ellen Johnson Sirleaf for 12 years. I take full responsibility of everything that went wrong in your government and in wrong. Also, very proud.
The internet is acting out. Somebody was calling the chairman for some reason.
Thank you, Chairman. Yeah. Thank you. Let me move this. Let me move a little further into this question.
Steve, let me end, please. I want to end this, but I say I take full responsibility for whatever that may have gone wrong in your government, just as I take complete pride in all that she achieved and brought us to cancel our debt, put our country back on the map, establish our integrity institutions, and bring government finally into direct contact with the people for the first time in the history of this country. Every Liberian know what is the work of a representative, the minister, and other things, for the first time. So I'm very proud of her achievement, and I take responsibility of her challenges. You may call it failure, you may call it challenging, but for me, if we didn't do it, I'm happy. I'm sorry we didn't do it. It's not for everybody to do everything. Other people should have come and continue from there. But I'm so proud of my achievement.
So, Chairman Bity, let me move this conversation a little further. I listened to one of your routine podcasts that you always do lately. And you mentioned that you do have intelligence. You mentioned, and I'm paraphrasing here, you mentioned that, you know, you have connections and you know people in the country and, you know, information here and there. But here's my question. Do you believe or are you aware of the current United Party, including Joseph Yuma Buaka? Are they seeking President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf support currently in this election?
If they are doing it, they're not acting like they're doing it. But I know that there has been constant interaction between President Sirleaf and Vice President Buaka. I know that as a matter of fact. I know in recent times, I know they have relationship. They talk. Again, Steve, when you're speaking about his former president, I can only speak from the top. I cannot say, you know, all discussion with me, with that with me. But I cannot disclose it because it is sacred. When Ellen is talking to me, she's very free because for the 18 years that we know each other, I've never betrayed her trust before. I'm not about to do it now.
So, Chairman Musa Bility, let me ask you this upfront question. I know you said Senator Darius Dillon did seek a meeting or seek the intervention of President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf. You just said that. Did Senator Yomi Kanga Lawrence ever seek any meeting with President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf? Are you aware of it?
I don't want to use the word seek, but I do remember that again, sometime last year, when the Liberty Party crisis was raging, she did call and say, Musa, this problem needs to stop. What can I do? Come, let me hear your sound, and then I'll call you and hear what you say and see what I can do. I remember that. And I remember that he called her, and I think they met. Well, I don't know what he said. She didn't tell me what he said. Even if she told me what he said, I wouldn't say it. I wouldn't repeat it.
Okay, let me move forward to another question on the former president. President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf. Now, you said here also that, you know, you would welcome the support of...
So let me say this. Mr. Chairman, when Steve is speaking, I will meet you. When you are talking, I'll put your hand. I've noticed that when Steve is speaking, or anybody speaking, once your line is open, you hear that maybe you have something open. Yeah, now the noise is ceased.
Yes. So,
talking, then unmute yourself. Go ahead, Steve.
So Chairman Bility, I hope you're listening to this question, because it's important for these questions about the former president. It's important for us to provide clarity and context, as opposed to people running around former President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf's support, whether it's on a cover or in public, by another meaning they're pushing her away, disparaging her, and so forth. But my question to you is, what would the support of former President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf mean to any camp at this time, whether it is the Black, whether it is the Blacker scam, the Cummings scam, or the Joweya scam, or even the Ganglo scam? What would it mean? Would that ensure victory? And how does that impact the entire election? What do you say?
You know, sometimes I listen to the United Party people and their supporters. They talk as though 12 years never happened. The very 12 years that they're going around to say Joseph Bagan was past president for 12 years, you got experience. They behave as though it never happened. Steve, you and I in the Liberian political space, United Party was nothing. Ellen Johnson Sirleaf came. You're not an original member of the United Party. You don't know the story of this thing. We the one were here. Ellen Johnson Sirleaf came when, 1997, when there was election, and then they had a coalition, and then she was coming to participate in the election, and they rushed the election, and by the time she arrived, the election was over, and so she was out of it. And then she was looking around to see where she can get party. And her good friend, the late Dr. Charles Clark, you know, linked with her, and they've been very close. And that's how she ran on the unit. She joined the unit party and ran on the unit party again. She took the unit party from the ground. I told you know, unfortunately for our country, every party in this country got traveling. And so, unit party was formed by Mandingo people. Edward Bingham Kesley, Sheikh Abubakar, these are people from along with other Liberians. It was headed by Mandingo man he ran on it as president. And so the party was dead. She took the party 1997. And brought it up. Participated, she came second to Charles Taylor, but Charles Taylor won overwhelmingly. And then she came back. After all of what happened, of course, we all know the stories. And then she won with the Unity Party. And then she didn't stop there. She built a coalition because her party, don't forget, her party was the Liberia Action Party. If you know Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, she ran on the Liberian Action Party as senator for Mosorado County during the Doe election at the 1985 election, 85 or 86 election. And she refused to take her seat because the election was rigged. And so, that was her party.
So between 2006 and 2010, she still wanted her party. That kicking you see in United Party something.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a United Party logo. It's a sign of the coalition. That is a Liberal Action Party logo there. So when they put the parties together, they mix the logo. So Bani Chairman, who became the standard bearer of the Liberal Party, during the, when the coalition was made, the chairmanship was left with Bani Chairman. And the agreement that they signed to align the party said that when Ellen Finney or two-term, the Liberal Action Party will produce the next presidential ticket. Go ask the people. So she took the party from the ground. The 400 and more thousand that voted for Unity Party in 2017. Chief, half of that party, half of those people were ailing people. And we're going to another election, you will see. You will see. I know of partisans of the Unity Party that don't care who is the standard bearer. You know how Liberians tie themselves to party no matter who is there. So there's no notion that Bad President Bwaga brings so much to the table. I want us to wait to hear him.
Let me squeeze a follow-up question, and Sekou, I'll turn it over to Sekou really quick. Let me squeeze a follow-up question. And this question has to do with the Liberty Party. Most recently, I listened to Kula Fofana on the closing argument, and I heard her assertion as to saying that Yomdi Kanga Lawrence still being the political leader, and they're in conversation with the Liberty Party. And to substantiate that, I did see a flyer yesterday from Colonial Kura, an event she had in District 13. I paid close attention to the flyer. It states on the flyer that the political leader of the Liberty Party with Senator Yomdi Kanga Lawrence's picture and her full name on it. Here's my question to you and the leadership of the Liberty Party. Is the ruling from the Supreme Court null and void? What's going on? Because we in the public, we are confused. You are muted, Chairman. Chairman, you are muted.
Steve, thank you for this question. In fact, in the last 24 hours, we have had several legal discussions to put an end to this nonsense. There is a Supreme Court in the Republic of Liberia, and when it rules, it should not be ignored. And the Unity Party is aiding and abetting that process. But we're going to stop praying. I promise you, we'll put a stop to that. And all those people who are members of the Liberty Party, including Darrell Dillon and Yomdi Kanga and the rest, when the campaign season starts, and the campaign for different party, we as a party are required to expel them, and we will expel them. Before then, this nonsense that nobody is doing, ignoring the law of the land, it will soon stop. I promise you, it will soon stop.
Thank you.
It cannot continue. It will not continue. And if it does, then we'll all assume that there's no law in the country. And I don't think so. I think there's law in the country. The Supreme Court of the Republic of Liberia has ruled very clearly that one, that the party has a constitution. Two, that it has a leadership that was elected in a convention that it recognizes, and that the decisions of that leadership is valid. And yet, Yombly, the Unity Party, continue to violate. Now, I told you, that political party does not see itself as an opposition party. It sees itself as a ruling party, so they think that they're still running the country. And so they can do whatever they want to do. But it will stop. And very soon it will stop.
Thank you.
You know, this man, I have dared them, and I will dare them tonight. They say they sign an agreement with nobody. I'll dare them. If they have balls, let them put the agreement on. Somebody send me a paper of trying to say, I want an agreement where you know the party stand and you please stand at Liberty Party. It didn't go low for different party to run on in this election in Matimani. They are lucky they are with the MDR, so they will probably run on the MDR ticket. I defy Unity Party to put one document outside. I got a Liberty Party name on it, and then they sign as Unity Party. Then they will do it. I'm waiting for them.
Thank you,
bunch of non-scores.
Mr. Kana, it's up to you, please.
Thank you so much. Thank you, folks. Thank you for following SKTV. Today, we are privileged to have with us Mr. Chairman Dr. Musa Hassan Bility, Chairman of the Opposition Collaborating Political Parties. Those of you listening to us in Liberia, I want to say thank you very much for sticking up to your radio station. And whether you are in your car, in your bus, you don't need to worry about, you know, data. Just tune to Truth FM and you will follow SKTV every day, 6 to 8 p.m. Liberian time. So, Chairman Bility, I want to kind of switch the conversation to the CPP.
Thank you.
And the reason for that is that I want some positivity here tonight. First of all, while we were talking, Orita sent $50 to SKTV to support SKTV. Orita, thank you so much. We appreciate it. They don't, people don't like to call their name. I didn't call last name, but we got plenty of Orita here. But I'll let it call. We appreciate people. Thank you so much for sending $50 to SKTV. Mr. Chairman, we were shocked and move many Liberians by the show of human being in Grand Bassa County. First in Nimba, in Grand Bassa, and then in Bourne County. The cry yesterday, it was almost like this was in Monrovia, where we have all the population, or the majority of the people. So where next? For the UP, because for me, for the CPP, because it's like you guys, everywhere you go, I mean, the cry is just people are following and people are supporting. So, what next?
Sigu, the people have ran behind Unity Party and CDC for 18 years, and both of them have everything that we have today as a country, as a structure, is Unity Party and CDC. You think they don't want to try something different? You think they don't want to try something? You think that the people are just fixed into two things? No, Sego. The people will choose somebody other than the Unity Party and the CDC, and the CDC. And that will be the CPP. Hey, give. It's very simple. First of all, for the rational mind, if you have bad friends and butter, there are questions. But if you really bugger, the person you were sitting by for 2 years is not openly and enthusiastically supporting him. Then he comes again and say, but the person he himself chose to sit by him is also not supporting him. Does that ring a bell?
Who is that?
Nogwe has declared for George Weah. You know, these people, they are in fantasy. They live in a grand, what the white men call illusion grandeur. They living in a war. My brother, we have more than 20 political parties in Liberia. Even the NDR, that has, in my calculation, the NDR did them a favor. I gave them a lifeline that they did not have. They have not even signed an agreement with that party. Today, there is confusion of who is going to be representative for the United Party ticket. There is no alliance. We're going to registration time, 25 days for political parties to register. Yet, if they are an alliance, it has not been recognized by the Election Commission. You cannot deal with your own system. The other day, one of the parties still can't even ask me, say, you don't criticize the government. Oh, me, I'm on a radio. I don't play that. But where are you official there? When last did you hear from the party lately? And I'm more Ali impersonating now, like the spokesperson for the party. These are critical questions that people will ask. What happened to Nokwe that was sitting down with VP Baga? Why is
Sitting down with VP Boakai, but we know for sure that Nukwe spent millions of dollars of his own money. As a matter of fact, that's why Nukwe was selected by Joseph Boakai. You always found somebody to spend the money for them. But then right after, I'm told, terribly, that after that election, when he lost the election, Boakai never called Nukwe back to talk to him. He couldn't speak from him. The person told me, saying Nukwe was very, very disappointed, saying that Boakai is ungrateful. So the question I want to ask you now, Mr. Chairman, you still didn't answer my other question, because the momentum of the CPP, we are seeing it everywhere. We have seen it in Monsovado. We have seen it in Nimba. We have seen it in Basel, Bond County. Where next? Because, I mean, this is scary. It's like
the planning is going on right now. So I know that we got two big counties to do. I don't know which one will come first. I know we are Nimba, and I hope we are Magibi. You know, but I don't know which one is coming first. So this is, we have a campaign strategy, my brother. We have a campaign strategy.
So knowing Alexander Kumis, being close to Kumis, what are his moods right now? What are you seeing? Is he staying the same Alexander Kumis used to know a few months back, or are you seeing some level of energy and enthusiasm and excitement?
This is the smoothest guy that I have ever seen. What do I mean? He has this level dominion. Whether we're in crisis, whether during the, but for the first time, ABC looked me in the eye and said, Musa, you're right. We're going to win this, and we're going to win this big time.
Hmm.
Yes. And he was that chief. The man went to Southeast. He been to Nimba over 20 times. He going Mosorado. As I speak to you right now, he's in Magibi. You know, it's not about rallies. When you see all you rally, say, well, I mean, we finish working. He's going to meet community leaders. You know, you will go to a community of 25 person, you see coming there. Let them stand on there and keep the key of their vote in the vault.
I think I want to ask one.
Say, well, this guy, before I say that, this guy came 1 year before the 2017 election and came fourth. Since then, he has not left. In his surrounding, 90% of the people that are with him right now were not with him. They say the mayor 7%. I wish you luck.
So, Mr. Chairman, after this question, we will take a few calls in Liberia. I know we are running out of time now because I promise you, I will not keep you for a long time, but you also keep late. So,
yeah, I know. No, I'll be here for my 1 hour, no problem.
So the question I want to ask you is that the election is hard for anybody to win first round. Some people believe that TPP will win first round. Some CPP supporters, they are so convinced and confident. But what I'm seeing and what we have, you know, witnessed for the past few months, especially since the announcement of both running mates, the momentum is on the CPP side. However, I'm seeing some unusual collaboration somehow from the Liberian people. Majority of the people that we have talked to are saying either Kumis or Lajawiya State. It seems like the entire nation is conspiring against the Unity Party. Why so?
Yego, I know that from the day CDC was formed, it got 30% of the vote, and that vote has not left it. But I know the other 65%, for you to get it, you got to work for it. Unity Party is not working. And also, Liberians are forward-moving people. If you go back to the situation where you're going back to the Unity Party, it's almost like our country has been turned into a two-party state. It's either CDC or UP. That's not what you want. And then it's what they call the thing 6 and 7. So right now, what we are doing is to tell a people, and it's resonating with them, there's no risk in trying something new. When you know the one that you have as a choice, you know what they want to do already. So it's okay to risk with someone that has a good record, two people that you cannot put anything on, versus people that you can put everything on. So we can work. Electoral people are very clear. So CDC is going to get a 60%, but they will not be retained. They will be removed from power. What move then?
Solomon, thank you so much, Mr. Chairman. Solomon, go ahead and take 5 calls in Liberia if you can. Let's take 5 calls. Let's hear from the Liberian people listening to the chairman here. Let it, you know, participate in this very informative conversation. Let me, you're unmuted.
All right. Yes, thank you so much, Seku, for the opportunity. So this is Truth Radio 96.1. You are listening to the SK TV program with Seku, Steve, and the national chairman of the CPP Collaborating Political Party. Yeah, in presence of Master Musa Hassan Bility to make your view here this evening. You can comment, call 0776923541 is the number to call and make your point. 0776923541, and you will be heard this evening. Again, 0776923541, make your comment this evening on the program SKTV. We have roughly 4 minutes past the hour, 8 p.m. from the city of Pinville outside Monrovia, Liberia. Yeah, we have a caller on the line. Let me see. Good evening, caller. Hello?
Hello, how are you this evening?
Yeah, you are live.
Okay, this is CPE, and I'm calling from Kibi County.
Okay.
All right, I'm calling you this evening, and I thank Mr. Bility for coming in to make some clarity, but I beg to correct his sense of history concerning the 2017 election that he mentioned Kumi came fourth. No, Kumi came fifth place anyway. But that's not an issue. We're following it, and I, at the end of the day, after all the legal proceedings with the Liberty Party between you and you, you know, right now, what I consider right now, what we consider right now, is for the moving train to take back at the presidency. I thank you.
All right, thank you. We have another caller. Good evening, caller. Hello? Hello? Yeah, the alarm is Jamie. It's that kind of Jamie. So we have, you know, a little technical problem here. But 0776923541. Four more calls to go. 0776923541. Make your point this evening.
And then if on the program SKTV. Because I'm not coming in, we can just stop it. I have one more last question to ask, and we'll go to Steve.
Yes, let me take the other call right here. Let me take the call. Good evening.
Hello.
You are live. Make your point. All right, thank you. Another caller, let's take the caller. Good evening, caller.
Yeah, good evening.
Yeah, you are live on Truth FM and also SKTV. Hello? Another caller. Hello, caller?
Yes, good evening.
Yeah, your name and where are you calling from? Okay, make your point quickly.
Well, let me say thank you to you, the Honorable Musa Bility. But what I get to say to Musa Bility is that you are making an error. The Liberian people mind are already open, and we want to see the reason for which that the former president, Eddie Jones, said he does not want Joseph Waga to be president. We, the Liberian people, we decide to know that reason. That's why we are chasing now. We are elevating Ambassador Joseph Ibaka to be the next president of Liberia. Mind you, if Kumi thinks that he will go far, then he will be making mistake because people are most likely going to mislead him, and he will never even get the vote that he expects.
All right, thank you. Yeah, the last caller. Good evening, caller. You are the last. Hello. All right. Let me just take this last call. Hello? Come in. Good evening, caller.
Yeah, good evening.
Your name and where are you calling from?
I'm Daniel Colley. I'm calling from the Ghana field.
Yeah, make your point quickly. 30 seconds.
I want to extend my thank and appreciation to the chairman and also to the host. But my question to the chairman is that we are talking about opposition unity, but each time you're discussing anything on SKTV, you're always attacking the UK, more especially Ambassador Baka. Why? So in case Kumi going in the second round, do you expect Waka supporters to support him this time attacking them? Will it be feasible?
All right. Thank you. They will respond to you. Yes, Sekou.
Thank you so much, Solomon, for that marvelous job. We appreciate it. So the chairman is here. The chairman will be here to answer those questions. So, Mr. Yes. Chairman, I want to give you, I think you, there were not a lot of questions, you know, from those callers.
Yeah, let me just run through that. I want to talk to the last caller who said that we attack opposition. No, I'm not here for hypocrisy. Have you watched Spoon? Do you watch Spoon Network? Do you know what those people are doing to us as opposition? Don't bring that nonsense to me. Go to your United Party people and tell them, say, if they want us to talk opposition unity, they must stop attacking. But if they don't stop attacking, we will attack. And every time they send one bullet, we'll send five. This is a war of attrition. You can't come. I mean, we started this thing here knowing very well that we are all on the same side as opposition. They left the CPP. They left the CPP. And by the, before the election, the real story behind the CPP will come out. I promise it to you. And it will not come from you. It will come from different source. What everything that happened in CPP happened. It's coming in the next 2 weeks. The public will know. So you think I hear to come babysit you? I'm not going to babysit you. You won't go to the same question to you too. So if you go to second round, the way you're talking to us, the way you're insulting us, the way you're calling us all kinds of names, you will come to us to say we're going to support you. Don't bring that nonsense to me. I'm not here for that. No opposition unity. If a United Party is not opposition party, I told you, it's a former ruling party. It's never for opposition. It's never for opposition. You will see, let me tell you something else. Opposition party will begin to come together. I can't tell you more than that. But you will see it in the coming days. Opposition party will begin to come together. That's a real opposition.
Real opposition, so not a former ruling
party. United Party is a former ruling party. They have the ruling party mentality. They, for them, it's to get back to power. It's not to get power to change anything. It's to get back to power. We have a different mission. Alex Comey is not getting back to power. He wants to get the power to change the way the people live. Two different things. To the power been to the mansion for 2 years. So you want to go back. All of them over there, that you see them making all these mobs today, running up and down here, they've been in the government. Mo Ali being in the government. And Eugene Fagon, I mean, can you imagine? You know, the party have a Eugene Fagon, the man who disparaged you for 5 years. I mean, amen. You have that man speaking for you, insulting us. You know, I know why UP is doing this. Because they know they ain't going nowhere. Because believe me, if you know the party were going somewhere, they would not be treating the CPP the way they're treating us. You know, but they know they're not going nowhere.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I want to ask you this question. Maybe this will be my last question to you. Hopefully, if we can take 2 questions from the diaspora, because you got a lot of supporters here, maybe they want to hear from you. However, something happened on a sister network a few days ago involving one of the panelists, Jeff Hassan. He mentioned Spoon Network CEO, or former CEO. I still believe he's a CEO. And alleging that he having some, you know, extramarital affairs with somebody, one of the panelists. And even though he did not call me, but a lot of people assumed that it was a particular person. Now there were a lot of misreactions. And some people actually blamed the network and the post by the network. And I know very well they did not allow Kefasan to continue what he was doing and what he was saying. They stopped him. And we all came in, you know, told him to stop. And that was finished. But yet, some CPP members are still concerned about that. They are even blaming each other, blaming other people for not condemning, for condemning, and this and that. Even some people are even calling on their friends not to watch the closing argument. For me, I think that's unfair. But what do you have to say about the whole problem? And what do you have to tell the CPP people today as the chairman on that incident?
Thank you. Thank you, Sebu. Look, I know that this is a very sensitive issue. But sometimes as leader, you have to make tough calls. I believe that the manner in which the closing argument network handled the situation was very poor or very bad. It was not acceptable. Like you said, even though Kev did not call names, but he did not take into consideration the injury that such utterances would cause even viewers or individuals across, you know, the aisle. And I think that was wrong. And as all of these guys are my friends, and they know how I feel about it, and I think that as a network, those kind of things should not be allowed to be put on a network. No matter how someone is angry, and if the person begins to show that anger, there have to be someone who can control the process to avoid the wrong audience from hearing something that in the first place they're not supposed to hear. And again, I'm in a difficult situation because I don't want to call names, but it has caused injury. And at the end of the day, the closing argument should have done more than they did. They should have apologized in a more, and I think that they owe us that apology. But the day I go on the network, I would insist that they do. Because at the end of the day, Stanton is going down. You have to be careful. He's looking for people to go down. You can't help him to do that. And I think, unfortunately, what Kev did is to help Stanton to bring down more people. And at the end of the day, he's not even worth that. I would have been more forceful if he had named someone, and I'm told that because someone is being alleged or assumed by the public to be the person that he's speaking to, and I think it's unfair to that person, because at the end of the day, if I make an allegation, I'll be straightforward, but that allegation should not. Stanton Witherspoon should not push any man to go beyond and above certain level. Because where we are, where our country is, there's certain things you can't do. Every day, Eugene Fagon and other people call me, the common criminal, every day on that network. But I can't call them criminal bad simply because I can call them other names, what I know them to be. But for me to call them criminal, I must see them involved in criminal act. So yes, the network did not manage it properly.
they should have immediately acted to stop Kev from speaking. And the photo, because it was clear that he was in anger. And when you have a partner and the president has lost control of their emotion, you have to come in and act. You have to come in and take certain action. You know, not just to save the network, but to save that person or to save anyone that may be injured by the action of the person. And I think they didn't do that. I know that, you know, they would not like it, but I disagree with them. In this manner, condemn it. I think that it was not appropriate.
All right. Thank you so much, Mr. Chairman. Steve, unless you have a question, I wanted to take just two more calls from the diaspora, or three more calls, and then we can let the chairman go. You have a question, Steve? You're muted, Steve. We're not hearing you.
I just want to add one short question for the chairman while we take the two calls from the diaspora. Chairman Musa, most recently we saw one of the party former chairman.
Hold on, let me mute him again. Go ahead.
Most recently we saw one of your former chairman, person of Steve Zago, Senator Steve Zago, seem to be in for lack of better terms here, situation again handled in Lofa County. What do you say if Steve Zago runs on another party ticket? Is he automatically kicked out of the party, booted out? Or what do you say about that situation? Because a former party chairman like yourself, what do you say?
The Supreme Court has ruled on this matter. If you are in one party and you go in another party ticket, for you to be on a party ticket, you must be a member of that party. Once you are going on the party ticket, you're a member of that party, you are presumed to have lost your membership. Zago will not be a Liberty partisan. The day the net present their final application, and he is on there, under the flag, the logo of the United Party, that will be the end of his membership of the Liberty Party. And not only Zago, any other person, and all other Liberty partisans that are planning to support other candidates, they will be expelled from the party. That's what the laws, the party rules will say. The executive committee will act against them, will not allow anybody to be there. We'll do it. We have done everything that we are doing as a party because we find it necessary to do so in the best interest of the party. If it becomes necessary, we will do it again. Let me be very clear.
So, folks, we're going to take only maybe three calls here. So you can call. You have the opportunity to call. The chairman is about to leave right now, and the radio too. We should have left a long time ago, but they give out courtesy because of the chairman's here. And we have less than 8 minutes to be on here because there could be other shows on. Let me see this caller here. Caller, what is your name and where are you calling from? 732 number, last 4 digits, 0225.
Hi, Steve.
Hey.
My name is Sarah Snyder, and I'm calling again to say thank you. Thank you for bringing our chairman back on.
Thank you.
As usual, you guys are just awesome.
Thank
That's
you.
That's why every show you go on, I am there. Sometimes Steve goes to second thought, and I'm there. You go to, you are on the closing argument. It's because of you. I even tune in that day.
Okay.
But I'm grateful to God because my chairman is awesome, and I'm just praying that God will protect him no matter what comes, Chairman. Stand strong. We will win this thing. We shall win. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Well, let's go to the next caller here. Caller, what is your name and where are you calling from? 832 number. 55.
Yeah, good afternoon, Siku. This is Ali Keller. I'm calling from Houston, Texas.
Ali Keller, welcome to SKTV. What is your question for the chairman?
Yeah, Chairman, happy Father's Day to you and to SKD and your family. I'm happy here today. I just got a straight question for, actually got three, but I think I probably wouldn't have the option of one. My question to the chairman, by the way, you're one of my favorite chairman. Love you. Your supporter, your sympathizer, your advocate, they are complaining about Senator Johnson being associated with the Unity Party, considering his record during the wartime. He shouldn't be associated with any decent party. That's their complaint. My question to you here is hypothetically, let's say if you happen to go head to head with the CDC party for the second round and you need a hand to cross the finish line, will you accept Unity Party support considering the fact that Prince Johnson is on that party now, which your supporter vehemently condemned? Will you accept? Can you look in the camera and speak to Liberian people if you will accept the support of Unity Party along with Prince Johnson?
Thank you.
Get you to the executive marshal or you will reject. Thank you for taking my call, Seku. I appreciate it.
Thank you. All right. Next caller here. 612 number, hold the line. Let's go to this person right here. 980 number. What is your name and where are you calling from?
Yeah, good evening. My name is Augusta and I call from Charlotte, North Carolina.
Augusta, go ahead quickly.
Yeah, so I want to thank, and still I want to thank you. I want to thank the SKTV family for the show, and I want to thank Honorable Musa Bility. But I have a different view. So Musa, Honorable Bility, with all the Bureau press conference, radio talk show you've been going on, have you take into consideration the caller, the reaction of the caller when it comes to Comey and that of Mr. Parker? Because even on your own show today, all the caller I made from Liberia, all of them were in favor of Mr. Parker. The only few callers I made from the diaspora, that's the one I'm talking on behalf of Mr. Comey. So are you still not convinced based on all the radio talk show survey that you have taken? Are you still not convinced that Comey cannot win this coming election?
Thank you. So the last caller, we'll take the last call here. Caller 612 number, last 4 digits 0589. What is your name and where are you calling from?
Yeah, my name is George Ford, calling from Minnesota.
Go ahead, Derek.
Yes, some ability, every time you speak about, the facts, as it relates to our election. You always mentioned that, CDC always got 30%. And I remember there was a caller from Kim, he was disappointed because, he said the 30% does not change. So you're disappointed because there are so many disincentives in the CDC out there. So you think it's advisable for you to keep saying that, because again, you mentioned all politics is possession, that, just you're still in your 30% because we all know by the time he enjoyed 30%, he did not have a record. But now he does have a record, and I believe that maybe his popularity is now maybe about 15%. Do you think it's possible when you keep saying that? Now maybe George, we are still enjoying about 30% of the population.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Kelly,
yeah,
I beg you from her in contempt.
Hold on. Yeah, hold on.
Keep calling, say she must say to a chairman.
Yeah, hold the line. That person will be the last person. To close it.
Yeah, this is people here.
Who are you calling from?
My name is Dr. Emmanuel Clark. I'm calling from North Carolina.
Professor Dr. Emmanuel Clark, how are you, sir?
I'm doing wonderful.
That end of the minute, who put Joya in the situation you couldn't handle? On the book?
Yeah, that's me.
Okay, go ahead.
Look, let me tell you, this election that Liberia is about to experience is very vital. We are in a pivotal moment with this election. Let me tell you, what we need to do as people of Liberia, we need to vote our future over our fear, okay? By doing that, we will put this country on the path that it's supposed to go. So that's what I'm just saying. What I'm saying, the opposition has been making noise. I have been talking to people in Liberia. You know what I'm hearing, what they are telling me? They say we are being quietly effective. We're not talking, but the results will show at the poll. That's what I just want to tell people in Radio Land and those that are listening. People are being quietly effective. And of course,
so you think the result will be in favor of the opposition? And which opposition, by the way?
No, let me tell you, people are tired of my body, in the CDC. We know the criminal activity that has taken place.
Okay.
George, I knew him. Some of us, we graduated from school together. We had our first job out of high school together. We went to LU. He has no work ethics. And I could go on and on.
It's okay.
We were friends of George. We are
here. No. We gotta leave it at that o'clock because we're running out of time now.
Okay. But let me tell you, the opposition will win this election. I can see Alexander Cummings making stride.
Okay. Thank you so much. That's Dr. Emmanuel Clark, professor. Yeah. So, Steve, go ahead. I think the last call.
The CPP people here, and they Chairman Musa Bility thing, what they own, I don't know. But anyway,
but
where are you coming from?
Yeah, hello. This is Teola.
Teola who?
Teola Gibson, man. I gotta say hello to my chairman.
I said the CPP people just following the plane. I don't understand what's going on.
No, I ask you on your only catch up. Why are you taking a call for? The chairman is muted. I didn't see Teola on the catch up.
I didn't see Teola on the catch up today.
So you don't have to take a call.
With a white continuous, we coming.
Yaka with you.
She just been calling part to the assembly.
Yeah, you don't have to take a call, sir. Because we don't see. I didn't see on the catch up was there today. Yeah. But anyway.
But thank you so much for calling, Teola.
Yes.
And Mr. Khan, I beg you, the last CPP man, because one man for CPP call, one woman for CPP call. Let us CPP people for they can.
If Joseph Konto take it, because Joseph Konto be calling more than 20 times.
Yes, I'll call. Where are you calling from? Because your CPP put a trouble thing in your head.
We got to go now. We're running out of time.
Call, I beg you, Peter, where are you calling from?
Yeah, quickly.
Quickly speaking, I just want to commend the chairman. In studio, he always, go about putting on a show when he's on this platform. So kudos to you, Chairman. Happy Father's Day as well. Just quickly speaking, I wanted to just reply to the caller. I think two calls ago that said people calling in and the show which direction. I was in Liberia. Don't be fooled by these calls that are made on radio orchestrated by the Unity of the Party. The people are resolved to reject Joseph Boyka and the CDC. That's what I wanted to add. I was on ground. I saw it. And I know for a fact that the CPP will win these elections.
Well, thank you so much, Duke. Thanks for calling.
All right, Joseph Konto. The only reason why I took Joseph Konto, Mr. Chairman, because we still were leaving, I said last call. Joseph Konto, every time you have show on here, even at $5, at $10, at $20, he always contributes to SKTV. He be on SKTV from the start when he used to do show.
Wow.
Cell phone, yes. The guy is one of the biggest supporter of SKTV. For us, consistency matters to us.
Sometimes it matters to everyone.
But this guy is very consistent in supporting SKTV. Joseph Konto, you are the last, not the least. What is your question for Mr. Chairman?
Thank you so much for taking my call. I say good evening to our chairman. The best chairman ever that I know. I got one question for the chairman quickly. Mr. Chairman, this kind of election, at this point we are in Liberia right now, this kind of election sometimes require family of the Kennedy. Like the children of the Kennedy, getting involved with the campaign at some point in time. Is there any consideration to have Mr. Boakai Cummings and his sister, Ms. Ayo Cummings, to get involved with the campaign to tell the story of their father, who the kind of person he is? Thank you so much for taking my call.
Thank you so much. So, folks, I'm sorry. Some people say, Sekou, where are you going? I'm not going nowhere, but I told him I'm going to be here within 1 hour, okay? That's one. Number two, the radio, I'm over my time on the radio for 30 minutes. Hey, you're still not selling far? Anyway, 2FM, thank you so much for being patient with us. Mr. Chairman, thank you so much. And those of you who contributed $20 dollars here and there. We appreciate you. We say thank you. So, Mr. Chairman, run through those answers quick and free the
people. Yeah, the lady who called and say that she's been following me. So I just want to please let her know that I will, get in touch with her. I appreciate her commitment to the CPP, and I appreciate her outpour of support. The guy who said that, the 30% is less than that. Look, my brother, the reason why I found myself where I am in politics is because I deal with data. In any situation, if you have a particular party that is consistently getting 30% of the vote, you have to assign that number to them until an election can change that. As far as we are concerned right now, the CDC has been consistently 30%, 32%, and at worst, 27%. I can't take that until, with even the moderate election, they still got their regular 30, 35% number. So they always get the numbers, that is concerning to them. So I would like to wait until, after October, then we can categorize them the way you want it based on their performance. Somebody did call to talk about PYJ. Look, Senator Prince Johnson is my senator from my county. He's my compatriot. I have a lot of respect for him, and he has a lot of respect for me. I believe if he needs me, he will call on me, and if I need him, I'll call him. I have absolutely no reason not to call him if I need him to go through an election. The thing about election, it's not about anything else besides number. It's not about how you feel about people. What is happening today, where the United Party feel that Baga is popular and he doesn't have to campaign. Some of them are even saying that he should go and sit down. Why they campaign for him? Election is not about that. Election is about a number. I have an excellent relationship. And Sekou, I'm very, very careful when it comes to NIMBA. Because NIMBA has struggled with division, with too many, feeling that can follow the divide. My coming into NIMBA politics, I want to make sure that it doesn't further divide us. So therefore, I don't intend to become a divisive figure. I will campaign against the Unity Party. I will say absolutely nothing negative about Senator Kuhn. I don't have to say something negative about him in order to campaign against his ticket. I've never done that before. That's the same reason why some people do doubt my relationship or my opposition to Georgia, because I don't believe that to campaign against people, you must insult them and say, that's not my person. So the same thing applies now to Senator Kuhn and Senator Johnson. We have a cordial relationship. I intend to keep it that way. And I believe that if one of us will go to the second round, and if I go to the second round, I will reach out to him. I am very, very sure if his party goes to the second round, he will reach out to me. And we will sit down and talk and sit down and have a conversation as Nimbians as to how we look at our output on the rest of the country. So, I have to respect that. My politics, my outlook, my aggression against the Unity Party will not extend to the MDR, And as far as I'm concerned, the problem we're facing here is the Unity Party. So yes, I will reach out to Senator Johnson. I believe he will reach out to me if he has to.
Okay. So folks, one of the reasons why I was watching, I was told last time that the closing argument is going to be on every day. So they start like a 30 minutes after our show, so I didn't want to run into the 30 minutes, but it looks like they're not on. However, I want to say thank you to the radio station. I want to say a big thank you to Chairman Bility. Mr. Chairman, you said something, and I don't know if you want to clarify. I expect, and many Liberians will expect, you and the CPP going to the second round, you will reach out to every Liberian for their support, whether UP or other people. But asking for President Johnson's support, somebody will equate it to, well, why is it that you are demonizing, people are demonizing your supporters, CPP people are demonizing Payne Johnson or Boakai for having Payne Johnson on his ticket? Why would you go for a Payne Johnson ticket? Why would be Payne Johnson's position with the CPP compared to his position now with the United Party? Because I didn't want to ask this question, but we made a statement like that. I want to make sure you have clarified exactly why would be Payne Johnson's role. Ask for his support.
If the United Party goes to second round and Senator Johnson comes to me to support the United Party, it's not for me to play a role in the union. I'm not a United partisan.
Okay.
So the purpose is not for him to play a role in my government or not for me to play a role in his government. And for the sake of this country, I want to use the word God forbid. If we don't go to the second round, he's coming to me. It's not for me to play a role in the United Party government. I don't subscribe to the United Party government policy. I don't subscribe to his ideology. I don't agree with it. He will reach out to me to support him to run the country. That choice will be now whether or not the CBC or the United Party provides, which one of them provide a better option for the country. And that vision will be very important, not to be a part of the United Party government. So when Senator Johnson reaches out to me, he's not coming to me to say, come, let's go and run the government led by Ambassador Barker. When we are reaching out to him, we're not telling him to say, come and, you know, let's run our government. You know, at the end of the day, you have to reach to everyone who you think will influence the outcome of the election. I'm not crazy to believe that Senator Johnson has an influence that have impact on the outcome of the election. You gotta be crazy. That is unrealistic. I'm not an unrealistic person. I live with reality.
Mr. Chairman, I don't want to give you the opportunity to clarify because people can run with stuff.
Thank you.
I think you did clarify that. Studio, you have something to say? You know, we thank you. Other than that, Mr. Chairman, was that a closing or you want to give a closing before we go?
Yes, let me give a closing. I want to ask politicians who are currently in cozy relationship with Darren Taylor, do not tell your innermost secret to this guy. He will use it against you at the time that it will hurt you most. Be mindful of him. Don't tell his secret. He has no old friends. He has no old friend. He is gullible. He is ungrateful. He has no memory of yesterday. Please, this is not just for us. This is also for the functioning of the party because we are all friends. In spite of the party, we know each other. We don't agree on the policy, but we know each other. You know, I heard him last night saying that there's a brother, and I'm surprised that he wouldn't pick that up today. He said that Joseph Barker is committed to a war crime court. Darren Dillon said that last night.
Really?
Yes. I want you to go back to that interview.
No, I didn't watch the show.
He did say that. You know, somebody clip it and send it to me. And that he said one of the reasons why he's supporting Joseph Barker is because Joseph Barker has committed to a war crime court. I just wanted
our people to hear this, especially our people in Lima County, you know, because the deception that they are trying to move this thing away, one day, you know, up to today, they have not signed an agreement with the MDR. Why? Are they trying to play them? Are they playing the MDR? Are they trying to make sure that after the registration, then they begin to bully them? Nobody knows. But today, the agreement is supposed to be that all of the seats in Limba, I think with the exception of the seven, to go to MDR. But the partisan in the district also say that, but our party does not have a legitimate practice. So there's already chaos in the.
All right. We're going to leave it there. I think the chairman's line has been going off and on towards the end. So, Mr. Solomon Toby, I want to say thank you and thank the studio for being patient with us for went over our time for about 40 minutes. We say thank you, guys. I know this will be all because of the chairman, but the fact that we are enjoying the opportunity, we appreciate it. Our listeners in Liberia, they appreciate you. So unless you have something to say, we thank you, and you can leave if you want.
Let me just wrap up quickly. Let me say many thanks to Yada for this wonderful platform. You know, it's so unique for us to serve this nation. You know, the country is depending on you and I. For the country to change, it's you and I, we are to change it. So I'm so grateful for the gracious opportunity of being on this wonderful platform with you. I look forward to being with you next time. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I think we have had it a few times now. Today you were here. We appreciate you. And we thank you. We thank everybody at Truth FM. So Steve.
Solomon, thank you. Happy Father Day to you. Don't allow the East gentleman to stay in the middle of the Father Day celebration. You are on behalf of the fathers, organization around the world, who say Solomon is a free man to let to go chill. And we now we are no not behind him.
Thank you, Solomon.
Yeah.
Thank you, Solomon.
Yeah, but nobody's too good. But Mr. Kane, in all honesty, whether you like it or not, Senator Darius Dillon, whether you like him or not, speaks his mind, and he speaks it. I don't want to use the word ignorantly or blatantly, however you want to term it as. Senator Darius Dillon came on the same platform and told the Liberian people he does not support dual citizenship. When the Liberian people in the United States were giving the money to him. You remember those comments that yield a lot of backlashes? Now, if I were the Prince Johnson or the MDR, I would be very concerned because Prince Johnson is not interested in no one economic crime squad. Now, but here's the biggest part of it that's even concerning. Is Joseph Yuma Poaga even committed to one economic crime squad?
But that's if the man can make himself available, the people ask him, but Joseph Poaga is not available for anything.
Well, Joseph Poaga is available to where they want him to be available. I'll give that to them.
But to the Liberian people, that's my concern.
To where they want him to be available.
Somebody just sent off $40. Thank you so much. Let me see if they say, if they didn't say, don't call my name, I will call their name.
But you know what thing confusing say about the whole.
The thank you so much. Tell myself $5 and then
you know what thing confusing about the whole show being it today and Father Day program. You know what thing really confusing about it, Mr. Kane? I don't know. You get all these stakeholders them. I told you and the other people, let's de-stakeholder these women, if I can use that word. You said no, let the women be the stakeholder. You see what they're doing on Father Day? You see what they are doing? Are you seeing it?
Like what?
We need to delist these people. They're not going on.
Why?
Father Day today. What is going on with them? Hey, wait up. No, I'll leave it on you. Father Day today, what is supposed to be making sure?
For all the people then that sent us low contribution here and there, Majority of them are women. Like, let's say, you know, Romulia didn't say, I know she didn't call her name, so I will call her name. Romulia said, not $25. For then, the person that sent $100, say $25 for I call it. This is $50 for America, $25 for Melbourne, $25 for Abraham. So that was a female. And then the person, the two people that send money to Zelle, they are also female, I believe. I want to make sure. So you can't say the people there they don't do anything. All the people that contributed, mostly they are female. So we want to say thank you to them.
The people who don't want now, they say, we don't know whether female or not. So we got to look into it. And be able to what they call it. You see it? So as we speak to you now, it could be a man, get a fake me on Facebook or whatever. Or it could be a man using a woman account.
I can tell you 100%. The two people on Zelle, they are all brother. Brother is a female.
Who brother? Brother? Yeah, brother are female. I want it too. I'm on your
brother are female. And then the other person, I can't call her niece because you made me feel like.
Now you get thousands and thousands still hold up.
Yeah. And then the person, somebody just sent $25. But I want
to get who still hold on list, my people. Ladies and gentlemen, so who get
your list.
We'll bring that out of discussion.
The person that sent me, they send something, the person say again, no need, they sent $25. I feel me too. All the people that send money are so
female. That men ain't using that women ain't need because that
father to the I want you on your own.
A man using women in the account. See, gentlemen, no, y'all start using female in the account to send the money. Let's show all. Let's show support of each other. Let's show solidarity. Y'all be using the women in the account to make a load of
money. Why? That's support you want or you want the people they need.
I'm concerned because our men using women need to send. Look, let me tell you, gentlemen, don't be afraid. Don't hide. Look, it's time for all to step up. I'm speaking to my men today. What do you have been?
Let me see. The two people on Zelle, they are all female, two people, and then no, let me go to Cash App because
we can't authenticate that fact. We can't authenticate that fact because they're hiding themselves. So that means our brother, y'all, thank you for using the women in the account.
Another person that sent is when father, the person said to for May Bomb. The last person that sent this one father, the person that said, don't come on you. I think that person named a love. They say don't come on this. Anybody don't say
Alexander Bonham face. Just so you know, the list that Seku get, so stay hold on women and the important. That Seku did that. I will talk here today. We visited the list last night. So look, even people that are not even sustainable stay hold on anyone.
The women are topping the list, man.
I was confused. Yeah. They get thousands and thousands of women.
So the last two people that saying the $25 on Cash App, both are women. And before that, another woman.
Why if we look into it for two that men?
No man. Stop it. No man.
Gentlemen, thank you for showing us solidarity, gentlemen. Thank you so much.
Gentlemen, in your brain, right? Because all the names I see, I don't see no man names.
Where?
All the names.
Don't tell them my body. They cannot see it. Look. Don't see your letter out.
Your boy is sleeping today because he said a man that how you call it?
Sleeping boy.
The father did today. So the men too, they say they deserve it. So they too, they want a winner to send it to them. They won't say nothing today. So it's good.
Oh, next, so you're trying to say men and attend a sleeping boy on there? Okay.
No. Steve, I listened to some kind of podcast somebody sent me today. I laugh so hard. The children that used to be supporting Ambassador Boaga, one of them turned against Boaga because of the Costa business. I listened to the song today. I laughed so hard. Some of the things they can say, scary. The politics is so bad. So bad. But yes, folks, I want to say thank you to all of you. Trust me, we appreciate you. Your being here alone means a lot to us. Steve,
the chairman hinted on something just before we go.
Mm-hmm.
The chairman hinted on something. The folks, we are getting we're following the story, and we've gotten some serious hints with some serious proof to them, because we probably don't do gossip business. When you want broader information, make sure the document can win.
Well, before you finish, I'm cutting you off. Sanoyo Queen say, do all women send us SKTV support for Father's Day? She wants to say, I'm going to send it to her.
Say again?
Sanoyo Queen say, the money that people send to us, we should send it to her.
You see what I'm talking about? You see? Now you... No, go away. Go now. Say what are they?
Yeah, I said she said what are
they? That on Father's Day, and I don't know other deal. That on Father's Day, Sanoyo Queen could making that kind of bread.
I didn't mean to distract you. Go ahead and
no, but the tear body now said, just looking so gonna wait. The whole information I said, discombobulated now.
Sorry.
No, the whole information discombobulated.
But he said, hit that on something, and you have some information on it. Marcel, I got some information there. People are talking. Conversations going on.
So, yeah. Mr. Kennedy, the true revelation about what happened to the CPP document, the plot, the plan, who all were into it, their names, the places they have meetings, the things that they done. Y'all have not seen or heard anything yet. When we told y'all before that these people playing this thing and they lied, they decided to lie. That other story coming on now.
So Steve, while I was laughing at, this young lady said something that I've never heard before. She said, there is a waking up tablet. That she said, Joseph Parker can sleep for 24 hours. At minimum, that 13 hours. She said that when they do program, they were to put it to 2 p.m. because when the men go to sleep 8 p.m., he can get up 2 p.m. the next day. So she said the nurses that are supposed to be waking the men up, they can get the waking up pills. When they forget, the men will sleep for 24 hours. So, and then the funniest thing, my wife was laughing about it myself. I laughed so hard. She said, when Joseph Parker win the election, if Joseph Parker win the election, she said, the man will not sign no paper. She said, we just take the man fingerprint and put it on all the documents. She said, the man will be sleepy. Look at it, we just go prepare checks and prepare all kind of things, bad documents. While the man sleeping, we're going to take the man here and put it on the paper and loot the whole country. I can't believe that little girl was supporting Joseph Parker so much, but she said because the reason why she's not supporting Joseph Parker no more, she believed that Joseph Parker is now surrounded by so criminal. But when she said that the man will not sign any document, all his signature will be fingerprint. That the man will be sleeping, they will go face all the kind of fake documents, they will just cut the man, put on and go. That was so funny. I didn't like some of the bad words. But those things were really, really, really funny. I laughed so hard. Did you remember? But anyway, Steve, we're going to leave it there for today.
Well, folks, thank you. We'll be back tomorrow by the grace of God. The Father Day still continues. And as interesting as it sounds, Mr. Kane, this month of June, that's why I love June 4, because tomorrow starts, today starts a new week, but guess what happened? Another yo-yo picking up by tomorrow or by today.
All the people that are telling me, say, I'm going to send it to them. I'm going to send it to all of them.
No. I told you, Mr. Kane, look in a list.
But Binta, I'm going to send it to her. Binta, they're not still hold her too? Binta,
even though Binta can watch a show from Liberia, we respect that because the government said they gave them extra data or whatever it is. Well, we don't know about that one. But Binta... Binda and I'm still holding. So I will look at Binda.
What about Peter Gawe?
Who? I said Binda and I'm still holding. Then he said Peter.
Oh, so Peter do not still hold on?
But Peter are men knee. I told you today that men there. Are you? No, there's a kind of Peter. No, Binda, look, let me tell you something. We need to start speaking now. The if gender there, as we speak, looking at them, because they decided to honor man the Father Day program today, because the attention now on them, The one making the gas, I'm not even popping. We got issue with them. And the issue, we're taking it to the end of the year. We got issue with y'all.
But my father did today, but he can still come to be tomorrow, though. You don't have it today, I think so.
Because guess what happened, Mr. Kane? We had a meeting with Hakimi and told Hakimi to slow down. Yeah. Hakimi went to court and change your mouth and post more and in the game.
What about Regina? Regina that still hold on because she always
going to Where? Regina now has to hold on. The last time Regina was on the show, they were probably saying the case against Cummings in January. So now, what about Regina?
What about Nancy?
Lee Nancy, we're having a meeting later on with Hakimi to a lawyer. Then they got to go back and put a thing back in your man name. Then the each gender, then we'll what it call. Because right now, they're not together. We need to go back and
tell Hakimi. Just qualify all the Google still hold on them, man.
We're having a meeting with Hakimi tomorrow. Tomorrow, we're having a meeting with Hakimi and lawyers. They're going back to the court in France, Paris, to take back the small thing that they put in a woman's knee, to take it back. Once you take it back, it will behave. I'm sure when Hakimi pull all that trigger, how if General Nigeria used to be contributing there to say that trouble would take, we ourselves used to tell them, no, slow down the contribution. But send again a small thing and that trouble will take. But we, yeah.
But you know the show we'll do tomorrow, Steve? The thing I can do on Friday, we'll do a similar thing tomorrow. From the start of the show, we will open the line. Anybody who wants the link, I will send the link to you. I will take tomorrow as many people as 7 to 8 people. Anybody can will take it. That all they come here. Yeah, that's a bonus for everybody who are SKTV fan or you're not even SKTV fan. But you got something on your mind to say, you want to talk about politics, we'll open the link. When you come here, you will show your face. Let people see you. Somebody can be writing too much. We'll give you the opportunity to come and put your face to your words. Steve?
Yeah. You gotta be ready. BB boat tomorrow. We'll put you in a situation you can handle. Tomorrow.
Someone will not come though. A lot of them can be shy to look at it. Can look at the
camera. Then I can know what I will do. I will take the link and send it to the inboxes. Those of you who can be claiming that, oh, we still hold up. Steve, that's not for you.
Elvis page, that's still hold up.
I'll give it to her. She not only stakeholder, she is a sustainable invested stakeholder in the SKT.
You are very selective. The way I see you.
I'm not selective. Look, Mr. Cannon, I'm not talking about Binta and other people who get Nancy, then we get
Papi. Regina always on here. She always contributing to SKT. Be that thing. So, folks, want to say thank you, man. It was a very good show.
Thank you so much, Mr. Kane.
But some of you came by, Steve. The way she said, was that all I wanted to her? I can be dealing with Nif on the stakeholder list. I believe you now.
Who?
Stanley O'Quinn, who say we must have all the money?
You can be what I got you. Me pa, I've been telling you.
She said that the money she wanted. She said she wanted the link for the video. Not the money she wanted.
Oh, she take it back?
She said not the money she want.
She take it back?
Yeah, what she talking about? She said, "Not the money she want. She don't want the link."
Okay, Senator Queen say you take it back or BOU today, yeah?
All right, so we're gonna leave it there, folks. Thank you so much. Let me play. Hey, you know that song I played that day called Valet. Say value. You gotta value your woman. You gotta value your significant other, that woman, that wife, that girlfriend, however you call it. Valet. That's the French word. This guy's from Guinea. Valet. That's what I'll play today. I had to stop the music to say this. Yes, Shatta, you are a stakeholder. Steve, like it or not, you are a stakeholder. I just wanted to add that because I don't want Steve can disqualify my Google people on the platform yet.
Yeah, 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 do my way,